Hey, welcome to the second episode of my series, Thrift Store Tech. This also turned into a Hackintosh build, and I took a $15 machine that I got at the thrift store and turned it into this. All right, maybe it was more like this. So here we go. So this latest find was 15 bucks at a local thrift store. It's a Dell Optiplex 755, 2.33 gigahertz Core 2 Duo E6550 processor, 2 gigs of RAM, DVD drive, it had no hard drive, and just had the Intel HD graphics. The machine came with the serial number for Vista, but obviously I'm not gonna put Vista on this thing. The obvious choice would be Linux, but that's kinda expected and a little too easy. So I wanted to go a step further and found out that these machines are actually pretty good to turn into Hackintoshes. So if I'm gonna load OSX on this thing, I'm gonna have to beef it up a little bit. It came with 2 gigs of RAM. I added an additional 4 gigs that I had on hand. I also had a SATA hard drive already on hand and a USB wireless adapter that's compatible with macOS. The only other thing I needed was a video card. I opted to go with the Radeon 5450 video card. So this is an old card. It's underpowered by today's standards, but it was only $25 and it has incredibly good support for a build on these specific machines. So to keep it simple and cheap, I decided to go with that card. So with the things I had on hand and the $15 I spent on this, the $25 I spent on the video card, this whole build is costing me 40 bucks. So my first attempt was to load Sierra on this, which completely failed. I spent hours on this, could not get it to boot. Turns out that Sierra needs a processor with the SSE 4.1. This processor, this is the 6550, this only goes up to SSE 3. So Sierra is out of the question. Next step down is El Capitan. So after a couple hours, I had OSX 10.11.6, El Capitan, and I decided to put it through its paces to see how it worked. For day-to-day activity, this thing works great. Web browsing, word processing, playing music, watching YouTube videos, all works really flawlessly. The caveat to that is with the YouTube videos, anything over 1080p will not play, and that's not too surprising because even local content over 1080p, I tried some 4K footage, it just doesn't play back on this. The processor is underpowered, the video card's underpowered, so 1080p is the best you're gonna get. Apart from the day-to-day stuff, even things that I wouldn't expect to work worked pretty well on this machine. For instance, video editing. I loaded the trial version of Final Cut Pro X and it actually worked a lot better than I thought. Editing in 1080p video without a proxy was actually workable. Scrubbing wasn't exactly smooth, but it wasn't too bad and it was, you know, definitely a usable experience. The only problem is when you start adding in transitions, like even a simple dissolve, it would just choke. It wouldn't render that transition correctly. So the way to fix this is just to do a quick proxy for those clips. And once you do the proxy, scrubbing is completely smooth, all the transitions work, and it's a really workable solution for $40 to load Final Cut Pro on. I was surprised, really, at how well that worked. All right, so I gotta talk about gaming. I talked about the day-to-day stuff. I talked about the advanced stuff. You're not gonna expect much out of this machine in the gaming realm. Processor's underpowered. The video card I'm using is underpowered. The RAM is older. The bus on the machine is pretty slow. So as expected, I didn't get great performance in games. The only thing I really recorded was Minecraft. I got about 25 frames per second on that. So that was sort of playable-ish. The other stuff I didn't even bother recording. I tried a bunch of games from my Steam library and the experience was not good. So it's pretty much what you would expect from this machine. So one place this machine works really well is with the Steam in-home streaming. I hooked up this machine to my gaming PC, streamed a few games over, and it worked flawlessly. There was no drops. Everything was smooth, very responsive. It's not too surprising because all that processing is being done on the gaming machine and it's just sending signals back and forth to the Hackintosh, but it actually worked really well. So if you're looking for a machine that you don't necessarily need to run games on natively and you just want to stream from something like Steam in-home streaming, this actually worked really well for that. So overall, for $40 total, I'm really happy with this build. It performed way better than I thought. Day-to-day activities, if you're just looking for a regular machine, work great. The video editing, it's actually workable for basic video editing. Gaming, as long as you're streaming that stuff, it works really well for that. And I can't complain too much for the price that I got this stuff for. So thanks so much for watching, guys. As always, come see me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. I love meeting new people and chatting with them. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for your support.